there'll be an explosion. Barnier warns of EU meltdown if Britain doesn't pay Brexit bill. Michel Barnier warned British peers the EU will go into meltdown as the result of an economic explosion caused by the UK refusing to pay any Brexit bill, fresh evidence published for the first time today reveals. In comments likely to provide a boost to British officials, the bloc's chief negotiator warned there would be total chaos across the continent, with thousands of publicly financed programmes having to be scaled down or scrapped. The Frenchman's candid remarks came in newly published transcripts of evidence he gave before the House of Lords EU committee, which grilled him during at a special meeting convened in the Belgian capital last week. Speaking to peers, Mr. Barnier admitted for the first time that the EU would be prepared to accept payment of any financial settlement spread over time rather than as a massive lump sum, as previously demanded. But he said Britain reneging on spending commitments it has already made to the bloc was unthinkable and would constitute an irreparable breach of trust, effectively ending talks on any future trade deal. He said, "We can discuss the spreading of the payment over time. We can discuss certain European demands exhaustively. I am prepared to discuss all that, but we have to reach agreement on the fact that the UK has commitments that it entered into as equals with us. Pursuant to those undertakings, there are thousands of town halls, municipalities, businesses and universities that have undertaken projects on the basis of those undertakings and commitments. If we are to cut 15% or whatever that is the UK share, there will be an explosion everywhere across the board. There are literally thousands of programmes all over Europe under the cap, Erasmus, universities that have been committed to and to which we have said we are going to pay this much money or that much money. And if the British share of that commitment were to go missing, thousands of programmes would have to be interrupted. That is why I am saying that that is the main risk of failure that we run." He warned, "You cannot build a relationship in trust on a situation like that. If we do not find that trust and if we cannot find an agreement on settling the accounts, there will be no trust later. That is why we have to solve this question calmly and objectively." In his evidence, given last Wednesday, the Frenchman expressed frustration that Britain has still not come up for a proposal about how the financial settlement should be calculated and said Boris Johnson's claims the bloc could go whistle over such a payment had left him rather worried. He said, "I do not know at all about the financial settlement. I do not know what the position of the UK government is, so I do not have a starting position. Does your country recognise its commitments from a financial perspective?" If the answer is no, in the words of your foreign secretary yesterday, "We can go whistle, I am rather worried." If the answer is yes, David Davis said that you do have certain commitments, we can discuss the nature of those commitments and the legal basis. We want to do this work in an objective manner. Mr. Barnier expressed concern that disagreement over a divorce bill is the most likely issue to collapse the talks and hit out at former UKIP leader Nigel Farage, who described it as a ransom note in the EU Parliament. He told the committee, "There is no ransom, exit bill or punishment. All there is, as in every separation, is that you look at commitments that you have entered into together and you settle the accounts. It is no more and no less than that. It really isn't. We have to understand how sensitive this is, because it is the big risk of failure that I see in the short term in these negotiations. I want it to be made less dramatic and more objective, on the basis of legal principle, and I want us to discuss finding a compromise and a presentation and a way of looking at these expenses that is reasonable." However, he also gave a big hint that Brussels is prepared to be flexible and haggle over the final amount, showing a surprising appetite for compromise just weeks after insisting the EU position was cast iron. The Frenchman said, "When it comes to paying, we manage the budget on behalf of member states, including on behalf of the UK, and we know what legal undertakings have been entered into as well as all the projects that depend on those legal undertakings. A figure of 12%, 14%, I said 15%, did I? Is a rough average. If you say 12% to 14% and I say 15%, we can discuss it, can we not? Thanks for watching. Please like, share and don't forget to subscribe English News Hub for new excited videos.